So, if you thought you had a private life, get used to it.
Auto drive now disabled.
And we're not going to reclaim our lives without a fight.
Auto drive now enabled.
And you've been listening to Buccaneer, keeping the resistance informed. Keep listening, keep fighting, and remember, nobody owns you but you.
We live in modern times. Drones, robots, computer control, they all have their place. But so do people. And that place is us. Because when you need help, you need the human touch. Not robots, not soldiers, just people like you. The Metropolitan Police. People protecting people.
The bug, nibbling away on the rotting carcass of a once free Britain.
Yum, yum, yum.
Hello, Resistance fans. You're listening to the Bug Podcast, the objective voice of objection for this most objectionable world. I am Andy, not my real name, so good luck finding me, Monsieur Bloom. My real name is, in fact, Andrew. And I live in, note this down, a deluded pseudo-reality of my own making, which is, in fact, the most densely populated place on Earth these days. Overcrowded, some might say. Joining me, as always, my next-door neighbour in these Netherlands of nonsense, it's Alice.
Yes, indeed, it is Alice. Alice, who the bleep is Alice? I am not going to tell you that, but you can just sort of sense it from the timbre of my voice.
Let's spin the wheel and find out where we're getting today's news from. Here. It's coming from here. I must get a new wheel with at least one other place on it. And the headline today, Alice, our borders are safe. We can all sleep easy in our well-bordered beds. 4,000 illegals were deported last month. These illegal people breaking the law just by existing. And, of course, illegality is contagious. It can osmose through your skin just by standing next to an illegal person. So we've got rid of 4,000 of them. My question for you, Alice, is why only 4,000? Is that really enough? I will not feel safe until at least another 75 million people have been deported from this country. And I'm here in Britain on my own.
As a bleeding heart lefty, Andy, I would normally be outraged about this, but really, I think mass deportation is a very handy way to break up with a partner. I'm sorry, baby, I love you, but an anonymous source has reported you for snoring really loudly in a French way.
So, everyone out. No exceptions, Alice, not even you. It's for the good of the country. Everyone out. Unless you can prove that your family are in the background of the Bayeux Tapestry cheering on King Harold at the Battle of Hastings in 1066. Get out! Actually, that's not British enough. Unless you can show, unarguably, that your direct bloodline is untainted by anything since before the Romans. Unless your direct ancestor was personally responsible for building Stonehenge, get out of my country. I guess when you look at it, you know, the best ways to stop immigration, apart from obviously the end of the world, to make the place you want to stop people coming to as unpleasant as possible. So,
well, we absolutely are doing that, Andy.
Well, you know, fair play to the government for helping us with that. Another option, extend the White Cliffs of Dover. They've been resting on their laurels for too long. Very inefficient, it turns out, as a means of stopping immigration. We need to extend them by about another 11,000 miles, a full wrap around Great Britain with a special greasy coating to stop people clambering over the top or however they get in. Here's a quick joke for you, Alice, about immigration. Did you hear the one about the woman who went into the immigration processing centre and was ever seen again?
No, Andy, I didn't hear that one.
Boom. Set up. Punchline. Classic. For those of you unfamiliar with it, the immigration processing centre is, of course, where so many of our guests to Britain go for a longer than desirable game of involuntary hide-and-seek. You are listening to The Bug. I will conclude by saying, out of all the things wrong with Britain today, I think immigration is right up there, Alice. When you think of all the health professionals we've stolen from overseas over the years here in Britain, it's quite possible that all these people are just coming here to try to get an appointment with their local doctor.
Yes, Andy, certainly as someone who came from the expanded arm of the empire when Britain was still reaching out rather than folding in on itself, most of us just come here to visit our stuff in the museums.
It's the British way.
Speaking of international movement, Britain has recalled all European ambassadors after a spy scandal. I think this is probably a good thing, because British foreign politicians are always putting their foot in their mouths. How much worse can they do if they're not there? I mean, by definition, the fact that there's a spy scandal means that they were terrible spies. The point of spies is that there's never a spy scandal.
Yeah, but let's give credit to all the spies that haven't been in scandals and therefore might as well not exist.
Well, they've arrested those German spies in that SIRS crackdown on the illegals in Hackney. And I think that's a sad thing. I think I used to think of Germans as quite scary, but that was because I'd been watching World War II movies where the Germans all have English accents. They speak in that very, like, precise way. It's very, you know, we have ways of making you talk. And now Germans all have that American accent where it's all like, oh, welcome to the party. We're having a really nice time. Much friendlier Germans. Let them stay.
Well,
you have reached your destination.
It's not as bad as it seems. Honestly. I hope. Until next time. Bye-bye.
What's this now?
By defense or by force.
Bloody white! You asked for it.
On Buccaneer, we can still everyone for their own needs.